Computer, there we go. We're both recording. The hypocrisy in this business, all these gurus telling you it's easy, you can get rich quick. Here's John and Mary. Let's interview them. What you don't know is there's no follow-up on John and Mary. They did one deal. Everybody has one deal. Okay. But can you do it month to month, week to week, day to day? My business, my word of honor, with rare exception, makes money every day on notes, on passive income. I don't want applause. I don't, you know, it took me a long time to get here. But, and a lot of these people say you have to get a team together. You've got to hire all these people. You have integration manager. You've got to have your VAs. You've got to buy this application. You've got to hire this scraper and everything. All you have to do is just give good phone. Don't I sound like a broken record? I swear. I say the same repetitive thing all the time. I lost you again.
Sorry. That's go ahead. Choppy internet.
What's that? Let me check my internet. It should be good. Yeah, I'm on 5G. I'm blasting, man.
Awesome.
So the key is, can you do some marketing where you have a few good calls every day, quality prospect calls that want to talk to you, that came to you, text you, visited your webpage, are interested in the subject matter, have a problem or a pain. And then when you talk to them, can you not sound like a stupid salesperson reading a script? If you can do those two things I just said, you can make as much money as you want. My word. I make too much money.
That's a nice problem to have, sir.
It's a good problem. And, you know, I'm the guy, and it sounds stupid. It sounds obnoxious. So, and I don't mean to sound that. But there was times in my life I couldn't sleep at night. I was worried about paying the rent, paying my car payment. I've been there. And I'm a guy, you know, good family. I got my education. I went to business. I went to law school. Had a corporate job. I still broke.
Preach.
And nobody told me that the way you make money is to master the superpower of persuasion. Can you get another person to listen to you, to say, hey, you know, that Alan, he's got a good point there. No one ever said that to me before. No one ever spoke to me directly, honestly, with authority that way. No one, you know, when you have credibility, that leads to likability, that leads to trust. When you have trust, you're closing people everywhere, all day long. But nobody's teaching this.
Yeah, I know.
Would you explain that to me?
I agree 100% because I guess from the very beginning of school, I think you get trained to be a good employee, right? So
the dog at the table.
Right. So,
oh, please give me a bone. Please give me some of your taco. It's Taco Tuesday. Please give me something. That's what salespeople sound like. They sound like beggars, or they sound like they're trying to manipulate you to do something you didn't really want to do because you don't see the value in it. I can persuade anybody who has a need or greed or a problem, has the authority to make a decision, has the money to pay for that if money's involved or a contract or something like that. My close ratio is so high. I sound like I'm bragging, like a bragging jerk again. My close ratio is so high because I speak to quality prospects who have a problem, and then I use guts. Guts is a three-step system of psychology. And it's understanding people, it's empathy by asking questions, not giving speeches like I'm doing now. I'll stop.
I like the word you said, credibility. And I think that's one of the obstacles I'm trying to overcome right now is I couldn't close because of credibility issues. And
what credibility is in your mind? You're that self-doubt, you mean? Oh, maybe I'm not worthy. Maybe I don't deserve this. Maybe I'll be embarrassed or something. You got that bullshit going through your head?
I wish it was that, but the seller told me that when they Googled my name, something from years ago popped up and it just destroyed my credibility.
Go ahead. Hit me with it.
Yeah, you know, I saw this article come up. I hope that's not you.
It probably is. You're right. Yeah, I made mistakes. I made a lot of mistakes in my life. Financial mistakes, personal. I've made some personal mistakes. I'm a fallible human being, Mr. Brian. You're right. I guess, you know, and the thing about it is, my mother didn't raise stupid children. I learned from my mistakes. I apologize for my mistakes, and I move forward. I have one goal in life, to put food on my family's table and to solve other people's problems. Can we get past this, or should, can I send you a gift and I'll leave?
Oh, man, that was perfect. Thank you for that.
Don't apologize for things that happened years ago. You made mistakes. I made mistakes. We all make mistakes. Don't be subservient and submissive. Don't apologize for your mistakes. Just show me a perfect human being other than Jesus Christ.
That's true, man. Preach. But I appreciate you doing that that role play there, because I needed that, because I was just, of course, deer in the headlights. Well, I mean, it is me, and that was the past, and you know, I've moved on, and I'm trying to, you know, make a better version of myself. So
you are. You got to get it up here. Got to get it up here. I'm here to solve this guy's problem. I know how to solve this guy's problem. Whether he's buying, selling, investing, needs a little hand holding. Maybe he needs a little vitamin A, Alan. Okay, you can use that. Hey, sir, I'm here to give you vitamin A. That's my first name's Alan. Vitamin A, baby. You got a problem, sir, and I have a solution. Do we want to resolve this today?
Yeah, I think I do, but it's just that you're in New Jersey, I'm here in Florida, and you know.
And look, we're talking, and we're live, and we're on Zoom, and we have telephones, and we can text, and we have Skype, and Zoom, and FaceTime, and we have all this ability to communicate. So do you want a solution, an idea, or do you want me to, or, I mean, do we need to get on an airplane, and are we going to do anything different if I was where you live, I get on an airplane, I fly to where you are, and we're sitting across the table with masks, drinking coffee. Is that going to make any difference today?
You're right.
I know I'm right. And you got a problem. Can we solve that today? Or should I get law? Should I go away and drink coffee with my girlfriend back there?
Yeah.
Yeah.
So we kind of got over that hurdle.
Hello, Alan.
Yeah.
Hello.
Hello.
Greetings. How you been?
Good. Been out shopping. Now I got to put everything away.
Oh, good for you. What's for dinner?
That's a good. I think sandwich night with bagels yeah. And sandwiches or something like
that. That's interesting. Bagels for dinner.
Oh, I love bagels, and make a nice big sandwich with a glass of wine on the side. You bite into the bagel and you got the crunch on the outside and the chewiness in the inside. And what do you like on your bagel? Like ham, cheese, turkey, a little salami. Lox. Oh, lox. And we're going to have lox and bagels tonight, too. Little cream cheese with chive, some nice Nova Scotia salmon, $23 a quarter ounce or whatever. And then some lettuce, tomato, a little onion, a little caper. You toast the bagel so it's crunchy, and you bite into that and you taste the cream cheese and the smoked salmon and the bread and everything. And you bite into and you chew it, and it's so delicious. And you wash it down with a nice Pinot Noir. How good is your life?
You're in the clouds.
What did I just do to you?
You made me hungry and want to eat a bagel with lox.
You don't know it, but you were just hypnotized. Honestly, tell me honestly, you can tell me if I'm wrong. I can take it. Was there a picture of that delicious, chewy bagel in your mind? Was your mouth starting to, God, I wish I had one of those right now. Yep. I mean, was that picture, was that feeling, was that in your body at that time when I was saying all that?
Yeah, the thinly sliced raw onion with it and the caper.
Oh, and the crunch of the bagel and the smack. I love salmon, you know. Was that all in your head? Could you see it? Could you taste it a little bit?
100%.
What did I just do to you? What power did I just do? I put a picture in your mind. We're 1,000 miles apart, and I just put a story, a picture in your head. Why am I talking about this? Why is this important?
This is important because you need to get people emotional so that they would make immediate business decision.
Yeah. What happens when I can put this picture in someone who has a home for sale, for rent, wants to invest, wants to buy, needs help? What happens when I can put all this in their head?
How big is an advantage do I have when I can do this to people? When I flip that little switch, I get out the little timer, maybe two, mm-hmm. maybe three. Mm-hmm. Okay. And I put this in, sir, imagine you got a problem, sir. You got a property. It's vacant. It's costing you money, taxes, insurance, landscaping, security. You got a small mortgage on it still. You're worried possibly somebody could break in because it's vacant all the time. Do you really want to deal with this for another couple months, or would you like to have peace of mind? Can you imagine peace of mind? What does that feel like to you? Peace of mind. This property gone off your back.
That would feel great.
I'd like to do business with you. Can I make you an offer?
Sure thing. Love to hear it.
Would you do me a personal favor? Just a small favor? Would you say no to me today?
Oh, you know, I'm not like that. You know.
No, I want you to be like that. I want you to do what's right for you. Would you do me a favor? If this isn't perfect for your needs, for your family, for your finances, would you just say no right away? Would you do that little thing for me, please?
Okay.
Off the role play. What did I just do?
A micro commitment to prevent, think about it, or get back to you.
Keep going. You're getting there. You're getting there. I told you to fire me. I'm telling you there's no deal. Can I make you an offer? Oh, sure. But would you do me a favor and say no? What am I doing here? How, you know, is this the mind F of all mind Fs?
Yeah. Can I make you an offer, but do me a favor, just tell me no if it doesn't work.
Do me a favor, please fire me. We're still friends. I'm going to send you a little gift after we're done. Don't worry about it. I'm going to make a profit. Yeah, if that's okay. But I'm going to solve your problem at the same time. I like to give people value. That's how I run a very successful business. I'm sorry you read those negative things on the internet about me. You know, some are true, some are not true. Some are just trolls, mean-spirited and stuff like that. But I can tell you today, I'm an ethical person. I do business straightforward. That's why you got me on the screen. Can we do business?
I think we could. I'd feel better if you could you can give me the consideration up front upon signing.
How much consideration?
$15,000.
How much is the property?
$205,000.
You want for a $200,000 property, you want basically a 7.5% down payment or option money.
Yes.
What's the least you'd take to do a deal right? And if you got that $15,000.
Then I feel more comfortable about you and your credibility.
I know. Okay. I know you feel more comfortable and everything, but what would happen if I said yes to that right now?
I think then I'd be able to sign this agreement. Yeah.
What?
I'd want to do the agreement.
I'm sorry. I can't hear you. My hearing aid battery fell out. If I gave you the $15,000, what would you say to me?
I'd say, yeah, I'm signing.
Good man. Good decision. Now, this is a little bit of a problem. 15,000, boom. I did off the role play. Just got a commitment. I said, suppose, imagine, let's pretend I could give you the 15. We had a discussion and I got a yes, finally. Moving up just a little bit. I don't want to give you 15, but I got at least a yes from you, a decision. I got away from the think about it's maybes and everything. If you started backpedaling and give me all the bullshit, oh, really? I'm not the decision maker. Oh, I don't want 15. Oh, I'm going to wait for a few more months. Does it really matter? Even if I don't have the 15, but I negotiate like I have the 15, suppose, let's pretend, and then you backpedal. What does that tell me? Even if I had the 15, what does that tell me about negotiating with you right now for a deal and wasting hours of time?
That tells you that the motivation is either here or there.
It's not there. Maybe you don't have the deal, the authority, the money, the need, the problem, whatever. So even though I'm making a hypothetical offer, you start backpedaling, say, well, you're moving too fast. I'm not ready, even if I got the 15,000. So who's got the power now? Did you see the transfer of power? You said you wanted to give 15. I don't have the 15. I negotiated like I did have the 15, suppose. You start backpedaling. Now I'm back in control. So, sir, even if I give you the 15,000 and my offer expires today, we couldn't do this deal. I understand. You don't want to do it. You don't have the authority. Boom. What? See how powerful that knowledge makes me, even with a hypothetical?
Mm-hmm. Gotcha.
You see what? See right away. So, and then I can fire the guy. What?
Right, let's go through that.
I'm sorry?
Let's go through that.
You know what, Mr. Allen? So we negotiated the price, 205 to your contract. You wanted 15,000. I'm giving you everything, but you're still not happy with me. I think it's over. I think we're done. Why do I feel that?
No.
Yes. I made you an offer.
Exactly what I'm trying to say. I just have these concerns, and you know, if you could just, you
can't
know,
get past you can't get past your concerns, sir, even with 15,000 and your full price. It's over. If you can't say it, with all due respect, I think I'm going to say it's over right now. We're done. I mean, why are we here, sir? Where are we going?
Boom. And I told her that, but like, ma'am, I've given you another day to consider it. And
No, today. There is no tomorrow.
That was my mistake.
Remember, he's running on the beach with Apollo Creed. And Rocky doesn't really want to work hard for the next big fight against the Russian, I think. And Apollo says, there is no tomorrow. It's only now. Life is short. Do you want to go out with a legacy, with a bang? Or do you want to, oh gosh, he was always broke. He never had anything. He never accomplished anything. What's your legacy? What are you going to leave on the planet besides dust?
Everything that you own that needs to be garage sale.
But how do you want,
or
how
pennies on the dollar?
What do you want people to say 100 years from now? What do you want people to say at your funeral?
Assertive, straightforward, to the point.
What else?
Had the independence and freedom to not have to ask permission to take a vacation.
What else do you want to say? Go deep here. Get emotional. What do you want people to say at your memorial 100 years from now?
He wouldn't listen to everyone else. He took the risk and didn't want to be safe in a 9-to-5. And so he put it all on the line.
What did he leave behind? What's his legacy? What kind of man was Allen Bryan?
He was straightforward and honest, reliable businessman.
Yeah, he was a good
family man.
He was a family man. He was a good man. He helped people. He didn't leave any debt. He took care of his family, his obligations. He gave back to his community. He was a winner. We don't have enough people like him on this planet.
Winner.
A winner.
Yeah, baby. Diamond Consulting right there.
Yeah.
So, I'd like to.
Good recording here.
I know that. I want to re-role play how I should have handled the. Oh, you know, I just want this guy Jack to take a look at it before I sign it. Do you mind if I? Can you give me another day to look it over with him?
No. You know why? You know why, sir?
Why?
Because if you're that uncomfortable, I gave you. We've had a great discussion, and I really enjoy speaking with you. You are an excellent. I've learned a lot just from speaking with you. You're a fun person to speak to, and you're very knowledgeable. I could learn a lot from a guy like you. But at this point, in my experience, when I give the offer on a silver platter to somebody and they still say no, it's all. Well, let's be men of the world here. It's over, isn't it over? I think it's over.
It's a wrap.
If you can't say no, I'll say no, because as it says in my one book. Hold on. I'm going to quote myself. I'm trying to find the right book here. As it says in the good book here, the Guts Rules book, it says the salesperson comes first. Why? Let me find that. Why? That's so important. Why does the salesperson? Here's a good one. I have made a decision, Mr. Prospect. And that decision is we're going to do the deal. You're fired. It's over. I'm going home. Goodbye. What we talk about authority, leadership, strength. When you go as a beggar to somebody, you know, why do you think they're going to respect you? What do they really say? Well, I need a day or two to think about it. You're not allowed to think about it, man. You're getting a great offer here. If you don't want to do it, I'm gone. I'm history.
Oh, man.
It's not, my mentor used to always say, I'll be, because we're recording here. He used to say, it's not F me, it's F you. Is it all right to be assertive, to be direct, honest, straightforward, and to carry yourself like a man?
Absolutely.
Okay, stop the recording for 1 second
here. All right.
Because I'm going to, is that, you know, because I'm going to stop.